These are some strange, strange times. I just saw a video that was talking about, have we hit the bottom of the stock market just yet? I was like, this is a woefully misguided assertion. I'm going to explain to you why we have not hit the bottom and why the stock market is going to go down. I'm going to use things that we already know, and I'm going to use economic data, because if you're on the sidelines and you want to get into this juicy, juicy stock market and make some gains, hold on to your money. Just wait a minute, because I'm about to wrap it up for you. Why the stock market is in a lot of danger, and why if you start investing a lot of money in the market right now, you're going to lose your money. Welcome to this edition of Hustlers Kung Fu, which was sponsored by HustlersKungFuLifeSkills.com. where we teach you how to start businesses, manage your money, and a whole lot more. Be sure to check it out, and there are links to some of the best deals below this video. Here's something that a lot of people are not talking about. Due to the stimulus package having this 12-month mortgage forbearance clause in it, mortgage companies are teetering on the brink already. Now, what does this have to do with the stock market? Glad you asked. What are some of these securities backed by? Mortgages. Why are they backed by mortgages? Because mortgages are seen as a safe haven asset.
Right now, we have many people who are calling up their mortgage companies and saying, hey, I'm in trouble. I can't make my mortgage payments. And due to the Stimulus Act,
the mortgage company has to let them go off the hook. The mortgage company cannot foreclose. So there are many people who are doing this prophylactically.
Prophylactic.
Well, I got my job, I still got money, but you know what? Since I can get this, and they're going for it. And this is gonna trigger a huge, huge liquidity crisis. Because if most of the mortgage companies get in trouble, which many are already screaming that there is a problem, that literally the stimulus package could bankrupt them, people going to get money for mortgages? That's a whole nother video. Another reason that the stock market is going to go down. Last month, we had 10 million people lose their job, and this month, we're going to have 10 million or more lose their job. Many of the companies that are represented on the exchanges are not open, or they're not doing robust business. So at some point, realness in the actual data is going to hit their balance sheets. That's going to drive the stock price down. Take Disney. Disney gets 60% of its income from theme parks, which are all closed. They get another chunk of their money from movie production. They're closed. Macy's, which is also a dividend stock, they're closed. They're not making any money. This stock market is fueled by emotion and manipulation. Right now, there are many people who are like, I'm enjoying the rebound. Here's the thing. I've got a map on the community page, if I remember to link it here, of the coronavirus locations. And one of the things that is happening is we're developing new epicenters. What's going to happen? What's happening in New York? What's happening in Michigan? What's happening in Chicago? It's starting to grow in Georgia, where I'm at, which is scary. It's starting to grow in Texas. And what you're going to have are these rolling waves of infection that's going to keep many parts of the country locked down. And this is going to affect economic activity. I see a lot of stuff, but as a person who started and run a business, I know what it takes to run a business. And if your business isn't making money, your stock price can't go up. Apple, which is a dividend stock, is going to be hit. Apple stores are closed. Apple's iPhone sales are down. Everybody is going to be hit by this thing. And what you're seeing right now is FOMO, fear of missing out. Hey, I need to get in the stock market. I need to buy because the stock market went up when the report came out that 10 million people lost their jobs. And I've had conversations with people, and it's like, well, the stock market realizes that this is temporary. Here's some more economic data for you. Many of these small businesses don't have the cash flow or the cash reserves to weather this storm. So there are many of these small businesses, they're going to go out of business, and these so-called temporary layoff and job losses are going to become permanent. This is not going to be a quick rebound. This is what you would see in the stock market, that you would see that, oh, you know, we just went down and we're going to go back and the Dow's going to hit 35,000 and we're going to keep trucking. It's not going to happen. It's just not going to happen. Right now, the country just had that first punch. What I want you guys to do is to do your own research. Look at what's happening in Italy. Look at what's happening in Wuhan. Wuhan was locked down for many months and now they've opened it up and people are going crazy. Reason that you should watch this stuff is see if Wuhan has a second wave of infections. Because what happens in Wuhan, what happens in Italy, is pretty much going to happen here. Because there was this one guy who was talking about herd immunity. Except, how many times have you had a cold? How many times have you had the flu? There is no herd immunity to this thing, which is what makes it so dangerous. And right now, it is the leading cause of death in the United States. The leading cause of death. Typically, 109 people across all the United States die every day. In New York alone, 731 people died the other day. 731 people. So there is a suspended disbelief. There are many people who feel that this is a hoax. There are many people who feel that we should be able to go out and shop. And there are certain states that are reducing their shelter in place so people can be in church for Easter Sunday. And a lot of this stuff, because I said that when this thing started, that America was going to have the highest infection rates because of our DNA, who we are as Americans, home of the brave, land of the free. We do what we want. You can't tell us what to do. And that type of attitude is going to be deadly for some Americans. The stock market, once the true economic indicators filter up into those balance sheets, and they will, stock prices are going to drop. What you're seeing right now is just pure emotion, pure speculation, and fear of missing out. And also, another issue that's going to happen, as more and more people are laid off, there's going to be less money in the economy. For each 10 million people who are laid off, this is mortgages, this is rent, this is car notes, this is credit card bills, this is student loans. These are things that are just not going to be paid. And at some point, that's going to trickle in, because the big thing I'm watching is what's happening with the mortgage market, because the Congress doesn't bail out the mortgage companies. We're going to have a mortgage liquidity crisis like we have never seen in this country before, where you may have a great credit score. You may have your job, but there will be no one to give you a mortgage because they went out of business. I want you to think about that. I know that sounds really crazy, fantastical, but we're on the precipice of that happening because the Stimulus Act, which was hastily put together based upon the data that they had, because they knew things were going to get really, really, really bad. They knew it was going to get really, really bad. So they put this bill together, and as of this recording, no one's gotten any money. No one's got the $1,200. None of these businesses got the $10,000 grant. So this thing is kind of stalling out a little bit. The laws of nature, like gravity. If you jump off a building, you're going to fall down. And at some point, these laws are going to filter to the emotionally manipulated stock market, because right now, you've got all these people who are talking about this stuff, and they're not looking at the true economic fundamentals. If you look at the true economic fundamentals, Delta is flying empty planes. Southwest is flying empty planes. When you start to look at that the airline industry is losing like $60 million a day. Disney is losing millions a day. When you look at that, it doesn't make sense what's going on in the stock market. The stock market is divorced from reality. But at some point, reality is going to kick in, because guess when this happened before? This happened during the Great Depression. There was a crazy exuberance. There was all types of wild risk. And the next thing, the market started crashing for literally 3 years. It took the stock market 36 months to finally crash. And this is once all of the real economic data started filtering into the stock market. So if you are wanting to get in the stock market, and I'm thinking about it, I got some money on the side, but I'm going to wait, because I don't really see, there's no way that the market can keep going up and we're going to keep having all of these bad economic indicators. It just doesn't make any sense. It's crazy. And the government can only do so much. And this is something else too. There will be a second stimulus package. It's coming. They're already talking about it. They're going to put it together. And the first stimulus package hasn't even been executed. That's how bad this thing is. We're going to probably have two or possibly a third stimulus package because this is what everyone's waiting on. The summer should kill this thing. Except they're in Florida right now. It's an epicenter and Florida is warm weather. That's going to be the thing because hopefully this thing will start to die out. More people won't, less people will get sick. But I don't think that's in the cards based upon the fact that this thing is raging in Florida right now. Florida's an epicenter. Florida, because of all of the parties, the spring breakers, and people just congregating there, it's rolling through Florida right now. And each day the cases go up. This whole notion of when it gets warm, this should kill this thing off. Looking at Florida, that doesn't ring true because if that was true, it should have never taken the vicious hole and made Florida an epicenter. So for all you would-be stock investors, because I'm going to be talking about it on Savage Finance, right now, I feel that you should be paper trading. You should get you a Webull app or something like that. Start paper trading, start doing your research. Know what's going on in the market from a real standpoint because trust me, it is going to drop. It has no choice. And this whole notion that we're missing the bottom is ludicrous, as Mike Tyson would say. It's just simply ludicrous. I look at one of the things that has happened with America, the fragile economy. We have so many people who are looking to make money based upon doing nothing at all. And this is something that I've talked about before. You know, you go in the stock market, you buy some stock, you hold the stock, it appreciates, you sell the stock, you make some money. Or you buy dividend in stocks and they pay you dividends. But here's the thing. As long as you keep trying to get rich for doing little or nothing, the process is going to take decades. Because this is what typically happens in the stock market. You invest in some stock, you buy some stocks, you hold the stocks, they appreciate, you get wealthy over time. If you were not trying to rent seek your way to wealth, and if you were to start a business, because here's another thing. During this downturn, this is going to be the prime opportunity for you to start a business. Everything's going to be on sale. Building's going to be on sale. Houses are going to be on sale. People are going to be on sale. Everything's going to be on sale. And this is a time for you to, and there's going to be less competition because there are many of these established businesses that have really shoddy money management practices. They're going to go under. There's going to be fire sales everywhere. And I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but that's just the way I see it. I don't see any V-shaped recovery because, once again, the stock market, as I pointed out in another video, isn't a representative of the broad economy at large. It doesn't represent the economy. It represents a snapshot of 8,000 companies. If it represented the economy at large, why is van life such a big thing? 51% of the people in America make less than $30,000 a year. That's not indicative of a strong economy. It's not. It's just not. So for all you folks who want to buy stocks, I suggest you paper trade, you stack your money, you suspend contributions to your 401k because they're going to be punished for just a few months. You know, a few months is not going to kill you. A few months is not going to make a big difference in your compound interest. Telling you this mania, this fascination with buying stocks, buying crypto and doing these things are going to burn many people. If you go ahead and look at making money the correct way by forming a business or service or a product or something, it's going to be much easier and it's going to be less disruptive. Right now, my sales are increasing. I'm making more money than I ever made before. This is the power of starting a business. This is the power of putting yourself out there because I anticipate my sales are going to skyrocket. What's going to happen is the stock market's going to keep doing this yo-yo thing. It's going to go up. It's going to appreciate. It's going to crash. And then when it starts rock bottoming, and then people are going to get scared. People are going to be like, oh, I need to do something different. I lost money in the stock market. My real estate, and once this thing with the mortgages hit, real estate's going to take a plunge because if there are no mortgage banks to provide mortgages, that means you can't sell real estate. I know that's a crazy thing to think about, but if a number of mortgage securities, you know, I don't think they're going to let them go out of business. I think they're going to bail them out. Expect all the credit requirements to become very strident, to become very onerous. I see a period where we're going to go back to fundamentals and banks are going to be very, very careful without loaning money, without issuing credit cards. They're going to be really, really jumpy about that. If you want to get in the stock market, do your research. Go ahead and be a student of the stock market. Go ahead and get you, like I said, a Webull app or something like that. Do your some paper trading. Also, know what's going on. Because right now, I watch the stock market every day. And I see that it's been going up and going up. And knowing what I know, that makes no sense whatsoever. But also knowing that the human condition. Humans do dumb things. And right now, we have a lot of humans who are buying all of these equities and securities based upon it's the price is cheaper. So they're going to drive up the market. And then it's going to crash again. Then they're probably going to drive it up again. Then it's going to crash again. Then when all of these economic indicators filter to those balance sheets and they're like, ah, these stocks are kind of scary. And then they're going to leave the market and the market's going to crash. And it's going to keep crashing. It's going to keep going down. It's going to keep going down. That's my prediction. The way that I see it based upon looking at all of the economic data. Because this month is going to be really, really another 10 million people lose their jobs or even more. That's just not going to be good. It's just not going to be good. So hopefully this video finds you well. Hopefully I've scared you. Hopefully your hair is on fire. Hopefully you will listen to your hustling godfather, because I want you for the long-term viewers of this channel, how many times have I been wrong? How many times? So with that, I'll see you guys in the next video, which should be around here somewhere.